In today's weekly Forex forecast for July 19th, 2024, we are talking about the DXY, the EURUSD, the POUND-USD, the Australian dollar, and also gold. So we have a lot to cover because we did have a pretty eventful week last week. Even though there was a lot of sideways action, there are some significant developments happening that you're seeing on the chart right now. So let's go ahead and start with that here with the DXY. And you can see where I've kind of marked out a couple of factors that could be an influence next week. Now, personally, guys, what I said last weekend is that we could see a sweep down here at 103.50 or thereabouts before we got to move higher here from the DXY. And the reason for that is twofold. Okay, so the first reason is the fact that we had this candle right back here. So let me map this out for you guys, because I did talk about this last week, but I do want to reiterate what we talked about last weekend. So we have this candle right back here, this green candle. So what you'll notice is after this rally up here, we never got a retrace into that large body. And this right here served as a sweep of that liquidity that had built up. So this is what I talked about last weekend. If you go back there and watch that video, we were looking for a move down here toward, like I said, 103.50 or thereabouts. We got pretty close to that. And the next thing I was looking for, or at least the ideal situation for myself, was going to be a reclaim back above 104, which we also got. So we got the close right back above on Thursday. So this is, at least right now, a textbook fake out pattern, okay? So a fake out pattern like this, you know, typically when you get a sweep to one side of a pattern like this or a range like this, you get a sweep down here, reclaim up here, that is a bullish pattern for this market. And it's also a very high probability setup, meaning that the likelihood of the market moving up here, the DXY moving up here into this imbalance next week is fairly good, or even very good, I'll say. So this is the area up here I'm looking for next week. However, keep in mind that we could see a retest down here around 104 because we also have an imbalance down here based on this candle. So we could see a retest down here 104 before we see that rally up here toward the 105 area. But regardless, I do think that we are going to see a higher DXY next week. Now, one factor here could be this 105 area. So you can see that going back here, we do have a lot of highs off of this area. Okay, so we've got this swing high back here. We've got this one. We've got lows through here, highs, lows, right? So there's a lot happening here right around 105. And we've also got this trend line off of these lows down here. So I do think that this up here could become a factor right around 105 for the DXY over the coming days. And again, we could see a retest down here at 104, but essentially this right here is the new range that I'm looking for from the DXY going forward. So next up, we have the EURUSD, which we saw break out from the 2021 trend line back here on the weekly chart. Okay, so we talked about this at length. You can see where we did get a weekly breakout. 2 weeks, in fact, this will be the third week technically closing above this level. Now, the issue with the euro, though, as far as bullish momentum, is that we did see it come into this 1.0925 area that we've talked about recently. So you can see back here, this area was a pivot for this market, right? So we saw the market, you know, close above, close back below, very similar to the DXY, which is essentially the inverse here of the EURUSD. And you can see where we did get some follow through here on Friday. Okay, so first of all, we do have a rather bearish looking weekly candle here for the EURUSD. And furthermore, if you look here on the 4 hour time frame, we also have an ascending channel here that did break down last week. Okay, so this was a very well-defined channel, and we saw a breakdown through here. Okay, so you can see the retest right before the breakdown. We got a confirmed breakdown through here. Now, this is where patience comes into play, though, because you don't want to just, you know, right off the bat next week, or at least in my opinion, this is not financial advice, but you don't want to just right off the bat on Monday start looking for sells down here, just because, first of all, trading on Monday is usually not a good idea. And second, you have to wait for the right setup for that right, you know, or proper risk-reward ratio. So for me, that's a retest up here right around 1.0925. I think if we get that, given this fake out on the daily that we just talked about, if we get a retest up here, I think that could present a potential short opportunity toward levels like this down here, right around 1.08. Now, keep in mind too, though, that there is a pocket, okay, of support down here in this area. So off of these highs and also these lows, okay? So we've got some support down here. Let me make this green so it's easy to see. All right, so this is our support area. And the reason for that is we've got these highs back here and these recent lows. So there is a pocket right around 1.085 or so. And then below that, we've got this area down here around 1.08. And again, 1.0925 is going to be resistance. All right, so the pound is another one that set up perfectly last week. If you saw the last weekly Forex forecast, this is what we talked about. So if I move all the way out here on the daily chart, you can see where we have this ascending channel right here, right? And it's not perfect. However, if you'll notice here recently, this has been pretty spot on. So you've got these highs back here and you had these lows. So as of last weekend, of course, the market had not quite tested this area up here, but I mentioned to watch the area just above 1.3, and we got about 1.3050 up here before a reversal. This is also what I mentioned to members right before it happened. So if you shorted up here, obviously that trade is doing, you know, really well here, over 100 pips off of that high. However, going forward for next week, what you've got to be a little bit careful of is we do have this high from right back here, right around 1.29. So this area down here is going to be support for the pound to where we could see a little bit of relief here. However, keep in mind that the DXY just reclaimed 104. So that could cap the upside here for the pound. All right, so keep that in mind. I'm not looking for something, you know, aggressive from the pound just because the DXY is above 104. Now, obviously, if that changes, then this would also change. But as of right now, I'm looking for maybe a minor bounce from here, potentially a DXY, you know, 104 retest of support, and then further downside here for the pound. Now, one area where this market could be headed, okay, and it depends on what the DXY is doing as well, but we do have this trend line that we've talked about for weeks off of that 2021 high. So all these highs back through here, this level down here for the pound could come into play if we do get that rotation lower. And again, this is going to depend on what the DXY is doing at the time with regard to the 105 area on the DXY. This is why I like using the DXY, because a lot of times the DXY will show you something that maybe isn't as clear on something like the pound. But again, I do think that something like this, where we get the bounce here, maybe a move up here to sweep this high into this imbalance, and then further downside down here towards some of these highs, could be in the cards here for the pound next week. So yet another market that played out really nicely last week is the Australian dollar. So if you guys saw, you know, once again, the last weekly forecast, what I talked about was the fact that the market had closed just above this trend line from back here in January. Okay, so we have this trend line off of these highs. You can see even right here, right before the breakout, we got Friday closing above. Now, what I told you guys is that I was skeptical about this because this was a Friday close. A lot of times, Friday closes, you have to be careful of when you get a breakout like this. And sure enough, we got the close back below. Once again, I mentioned this to members, and we got a nice little sell-off down here toward this trend line. Now, on top of that, we also saw the Australian dollar potentially close below this. Now, here's the tricky part, though, with trend lines, and this is always the case. I don't care how good you are at drawing trend lines. This is always going to be an issue. And that is that, you know, when you look at this here, you could draw it in a couple of different places. You could draw it up here, a little bit closer to some of these lows back through here, or you could draw it a little bit lower off of the very wicks, in which case the market is sitting right there at support. Okay, so you could also technically draw it both ways, right? Both ways are technically valid. So if you were to do something like this, then what you can conclude from this, and this also kind of lines up with the DXY, because if we see the Australian dollar give us a little bounce next week, potentially back here toward this trend line, then from there, we could see that further sell-off. Okay, so this is what I'm looking for next week to see if we do get a reaction up here at this trend line. Now, what you're also going to notice is that this trend line up here is also very close to these highs. All right, so notice where this high is back here in relation to this trend line. Okay, so in my opinion, that's going to be an area to watch just above 67. I think 67.13, 67.14, somewhere in that area up there, I think could be interesting for the Australian dollar if we do get it. But just keep in mind that we do have this trend line down here, which is also valid off of these recent lows. But the fact is, guys, if you traded this last week based on last weekend's forecast, you did extremely well. And last up, we have gold XAUUSD. So this is something that we also talked about in the members area last week. So you've got these lows and highs off of this parallel channel that has developed all the way since April. Now, the market came off of this level last week, and the cue to start looking for shorts here was this candle on Wednesday. Okay, so this specific candle right here, we've got this first red candle, and notice what happened here on Thursday. If I even go into the 4-hour time frame, you're going to notice that we had a little fake out here on the 4-hour. Okay, so this right up here was a fake out above the level, and we got the selling opportunity right there on the retest. Okay, so that obviously presented a really nice short for a very aggressive move on Friday of over 2%. Okay, so going forward for gold, right? And I know that this chart is very simple, not a lot of levels on it, But there's a reason for that. I think that this channel right here is really all you need right now to trade gold. Okay, but there are a couple of other levels that you should pay attention to. So the very first one is going to be the trend line off of this low from down here. Now, once again, with trend lines, they're subjective. They can be drawn, you know, down here, maybe a little bit higher. But the point here is that if we go into the 4-hour time frame, I think if we look at this here from the lows, then we can conclude that gold is either at or just below it. Now, personally, I would say, because it's a Friday, I would say the gold is at this level. I would not want to approach next week on Monday trying to short this market without some type of bounce first. Now, the other level, okay, to pay attention to is going to be a horizontal level through some of these recent highs. And for that, I'm actually going to draw a square just because some of these highs don't line up perfectly, but I do think this is the general area to watch. And again, this is why I would not be shorting early next week, because I do think we could see a bounce from this general area. All right, now again, it could come a little bit lower, you know, down here in this area, but I do think a bounce from here could be in the cards. And we also have, you know, keep in mind too, a very big candle developing here on Friday, which may seem a little bit irrelevant until you realize that big candles like this leave behind a lot of liquidity and markets seek liquidity. So this up here is going to be an imbalance. So this could come into play next week, but ultimately I really think that the best short opportunity here from gold was this one up here that we talked about in the members area. And going forward, it's going to be a matter of just waiting to see how gold reacts to these recent highs back here. And also this trend line to see if we do get a short, you know, up here in this area, or potentially a breakdown here and then a retest of this trend line. Subscribe to the channel and click the bell icon for notifications. Don't forget too, to join us in VIP, save 90% on lifetime access. See the link in the description of this video, or if you're on the website, click on that join VIP link. Enjoy the rest of your weekend, and I will talk to you again next week.